This video will have a lot to ponder on. Sort of a potpourri of ponderance. And did you know this? Did you know that? Did you know the ancient city of Nineveh was known for what? Goat herding. Goat herding capital of the world at that time, really. And to this day, it's still known as goat herding. So, what do you say? Well, so what? You'll find out why that is very relevant very soon. No matter how much I try to stay away from the comet, I'm not even thinking about it at all. It continually, during the day, events, very unusual events keep happening that just rivet my attention and say, uh-oh. It is really the most important story going on, and it continues to be revealed that we are certainly have a high probability that we are in the times that has been written about in Scripture. Return of Christ, entering into the tribulation, etc., etc. And that ISON is some cosmic trigger to bring this about. What I was shown today and have been shown repeatedly is that there are going to be five impacts on the planet from this passage of ISON, whether cometary fragments or in the debris field, five impacts on this planet. At comet speed, I mean, these are not asteroids, you see. You know that Michio Kaku scientist guy who's always on television saying, Earth is a sitting duck for asteroids, you know. Well, asteroids are really not the problem, not so much the problem, unless they're really, really, really big asteroids. Why? Because the kinetic energy of asteroids is very low, because they're going slow. They're going slow. Very, you know, comets, on the other hand, are going incredibly fast. ISON is expected to be going 420,000 miles an hour as it goes around the sun. 420,000 miles an hour. You can do the math. How many miles a second is that? I don't know, but it's quite substantial. So the debris field of a comet that is going that fast has enormous kinetic energy. Enormous. So being impacted from fragments of a comet, that is something very substantial, actually. The asteroids, they blow up in the atmosphere sometimes and knock some trees down. Everybody goes, whoa, you know, wow. Now, that's nothing. That's child's play. So, I got a comment on one of my videos from a YouTuber, I believe, named Steve Fletcher. Now, he has a very interesting get, and I'm going to pass this on. He asked people to pass it on, and I took a look, I researched, and I said, you know what? It's very, very relevant get, actually, so I'm going to pass it on to you here right now. Jesus was asked, what is the sign of the end times, the Great Tribulation? And he said, to an evil and adulterous generation, only one sign will be given. That's the sign of the whale. And people know the sign of the whale means Jonah. Okay, Jonah is the one that was swallowed up by a whale and stayed in the belly of the whale for 3 days and then came out of the whale and then went to Nineveh and said, hey, Nineveh, you know, you got 40 days to go before you are brought down. I mean, all the stones, you know, they built with stone, I guess, at that time. Clay and adobe and stone, it's all going to, you know, you're going to be destroyed. So what Steve pointed out was that astrologically, if you take Jonah to represent the moon, and the ancients were all about the heavens, the stars, and the motion of the planets, the moon, etc. They really were tuned into that. So let's say if the moon represents Jonah, he points out that on October, what was it, 16th, the moon entered the mouth, as it were, of Pisces, the fish. And it stayed, and it moved through Pisces, like as if going into the belly of the fish, on the 17th, and then the 18th, and then on the 19th, it was expelled as by the tail, came out of the whale, the big fish in the sky. Then, where is the moon now? Where is the moon next day? In Aries, the goat symbolizes Nineveh. Okay, and Nineveh was the place where Jonah went to and said, "Hey, you got 40 days before the end, you know, before it all comes unglued. 40 days." Well, then he points out that from the 19th of October to the 28th of November is 40 days. And that's the perihelion of Comet ISON. So, interesting. We have the 40 and the 4. The 4 is the number of the Antichrist. 44 especially. 44 is 4 and 4 is the number of the Antichrist. It's the number of the New World Order. It's the number of dictatorship, tyranny, etc. Now, did you know that our present POTUS, President of the United States, happened to ascend to the high federal office of senator when he was 44 years old? Also, how long has he been in office so far? Well, how about on November 28th, how long will he have been in office? 4 years, 44 weeks, and 4 days. And what number president is he, by the way, just to round it all out? Oh, gee, he's number 44, president number 44. So, you know, you have all these things coming together. And more and more and more and more are just, it's just a vast outpouring of foreshadowing, of synchronicity, of awareness. Say, oh my gosh, this is, now, is Jesus returning? Absolutely, I believe he's returning very soon. And will the rapture happen? Here's another did you know. Did you know that very likely the rapture is actually a wormhole rapture? Okay, a wormhole rapture. That's what I've been shown. What's a wormhole? It is like a tunnel in time and space that enables you to go from one area of time and space in a particular dimensional vibration to another area in time and space in dimensional vibration without the intervening time and space being necessary. It's like a direct connection. You just go through this wormhole and there you are, right? So we think, how in the world are we going to be able to go to the place that Jesus has prepared for us? Wormhole rapture, okay? Wormhole rapture. That is what is being prepared for us. So, there's another thing that's just like, wow. Wow. But yeah, it's coming. There are many prophets from many different backgrounds right now, and they're bringing forth their information. I've been bringing forth this information for quite some time. My whole life, I've been aware that the end times are coming. A comet is going to play the central role in all of that, etc., etc. Entire life I've known that, but nobody really believed it, you know. And so you just do the best you can to try and get people up to speed. But a lot of people are getting up to speed now from different backgrounds with their own kind of contributions and sharing about this comet ISON that is coming in. Interesting. ISON, ISON. Isn't there sin in there? SIN, yes. And there's SNO, snow. SNOI, snowy. It's going to be snowy. Snowing dust, maybe. So, even though I try to focus on inquiry and looking and spiritual clarity and enlightenment, this whole scenario keeps popping up right in my face. So I have to say something about it or be derelict in that regard. Now, how fast is the ISON going around the sun? That's perihelion? Like 420,000, who knows, maybe be 440,000 miles an hour. It's the 4 again. Okay, now, you know that fellow named Michio Kaku who pops up on television and all, he's all over the place saying, hey folks, we could have a big problem with space rock, really big problem with space rock. Hey folks, he's always saying this thing, but he usually says asteroids, as we are sitting duck for asteroids. Well, actually, asteroids are not the problem, because the kinetic energy of an asteroid is very little, because it's not going that fast, compared to the kinetic energy of cometary fragments, which are going with incredible speed. So it would take a gigantic asteroid hitting the planet to have a really catastrophic effect. But cometary fragments, I've been shown 5 fragments. We're going to be hit by 5 fragments from this passing of ISON, whether it's to refield or fragmentation of ISON, I'm not sure. But 5 fragments, but they're going very fast, super amount of kinetic energy. So that is an issue. It is a problem, actually. (Clears throat) And when that will happen, I don't know for sure. I don't know for sure, but it's likely, you know, when the comet goes past the Earth, this debris field, it is sometime, I believe, in January. That will pass by January, mid-January or something, pass by the Earth, or no, earlier than that, maybe. But any regard, the rapture, Jesus' return, etc., it's likely to be happening during this time period from the 28th of November on. And did you know that 2013, December 21st, 2013, is the true end of the world that the Mayans predicted, because they didn't count zero. If we count zero to one as one, see, they didn't. Zero was nothing, and then one started the count of from one, from that point. So if we count that way, you lop off a year. So everybody was saying, hey, it's 2012, you know, 12-21-12. No, it's 12-21-213. So it could be that there is a rapture, or a wormhole rapture around that time, prior to the tribulation, which is likely to happen in January. It's very possible that space rock with high kinetic energy will be hitting the planet at that time. It's quite possible. I can't say for sure. I'm just saying that there's so much prophetic kind of information and foreshadowing, and the Holy Spirit saying, hey, look at this, look at this, look at this. I'm saying, yeah, wow. But still, my mind is not really there. I've got stuff that I'm more interested in, actually. But I cannot ignore it. So, there you go with an ISON update, and maybe something else will pop into my mind. There's a lot of stuff that is going on right now. I'm not focusing on it exclusively, but certainly the timing is very interesting. The 28th of November is Thanksgiving. It's also, what is it? It's a Jewish a particular feast day, I think the 28th. It's 4 years, 44 weeks and 4 days into this president's administration. Probably people will be coming up with more and more stuff as this goes forward. So the general overall feel of the times, if you just correlate everything that's been going on, which I've been doing for so many years, just a general sense, you have to say, these are the times. There's a lot of smoke. If there's that much smoke, there's probably fire. Recently, last couple days, I've been suddenly, something will occur to me saying, hey, what if you met Jesus? What if he came back right now and you met him? You know, how would you react to that? And I'm seriously thinking, huh? Well, did you know that when he came the first time, he talked with multitudes, thousands and thousands and thousands of people were there with him. He gave, you know, talks and sermons and he walked among the people, etc. The people didn't freak out. People didn't freak out. They said, "Hi, Rabbi, you know, can I ask you a question, Rabbi?" He wasn't like flaming, you know, and all this. He seemed like a fairly ordinary person with kind of a great presence about him. People felt this aura of sanctity, but still he conversed with people, normal people, Good Samaritan, you know, lady at the well, all these people. He conversed with so many people, ordinary, normal people. And they didn't freak out. Nobody freaked out. Some people didn't like him, but they didn't. Nobody freaked out at all. So why should it be any different now? Why would Jesus freak anybody out? He probably just seemed to be a normal person, easy to talk with, easy to relate to. Wouldn't freak anybody out. So I don't think that Jesus returns anything that people should freak out about and say, "Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh." No, it's not like that. So I would say, if Jesus returns, I saw him, I would say, well, let's see how you play in this time, in these days. Let's see how you play. We know how you played 2,000 years ago, how that played out with people and everything. And let's see how you play out now on the stage at this time. I would just feel that way. Let's see how it goes. It's interesting. It's interesting to see that. So I think we deserve it. We've been through enormous stress. The people who have been in the world, especially the last 50 years, you know, it's just like, wow. Because the change is so extreme, from like 25 and then years and then 25 more years. just unbelievable. And to go, to be rooted in the past, and then to be experiencing this rush, inrushing of history, or inrushing of the future, for the last 25 years, it's just been incredibly stressful and difficult. Everything's been just unbelievably difficult. So I'd say we really do deserve to see how it plays out. Jesus returns, how does it play out? What happens? And just the whole play, we get to watch this whole play. We should, we deserve it. We really deserve it. And I'm getting indications that yes, Jesus is going to return. Now, lots of people have various ideas of what he's going to do, etc. For me, it's the rapture, wormhole rapture, actually. I know people think they're going to be caught up in the sky and lifted up and stuff, but I think it's more like there will be these wormholes that will open up, so to speak, and people will just be able to walk right through into these wormholes and go and find themselves in really a paradise-like setting. So we will see. These are things that we'll see how it plays out. We'll see how it plays out. I'm up for that, absolutely. We'll see how ISON plays out. Up for that too. Not too up for it. Not too down for it. Trying to stay, pretty level, engaged, interested. They say like the best athletes, the most successful ones, they don't get too high, they don't get too low. They just very even keel. And when they win, they don't get all pumped, all wow. And when they lose, they don't get all down. They stay very serene, very confident. So that's a good attitude to have in these days, is you don't get too high and don't get too low. And you just stay engaged and stay interested. Now, for me, the issue is rapture as far as how do we prepare for that? I mean, it's a given that there's going to be a tribulation. And again, Jesus said, hey, the sign of the whale. Now, I always took the sign of the whales to be 9/11 because these big, huge black buildings that are like whales, and they, crumbled and fell. But this moon going into the sign of Pisces and then into goat is a very, very significant thing because it happened 40 days before the 28th of November, where ISON is now right just behind the sun, as it were, just going around the sun. Now, will it be visible? I don't know. The glare of the sun might be significant at that time. Maybe it'll be visible. We'll find out pretty soon, right? Very, very, very soon. So don't get all freaked out or worried or anything. Focus on preparation for the rapture. That's what I focus on here. So I do say some things about ISON because it's important. But again, the mindset of the rapture is what is important. The preparation is what's important. And that continues on this channel with all the videos here. Because that's what the whole thing's all about. You see, I know there's a lot of doom and gloomers saying, the sky is falling. I'm not interested in that. I'm interested in the rapture, because sidestepping. I've always said, prepare to sidestep this trouble. How do you sidestep it? Through a wormhole, okay? A wormhole is as if you're kind of, going sideways, sidestepping away from it. Something that people don't think about. They think, oh, we're going to have to go up in the sky or something. Where do we go, hide in Canada or somewhere? No, go through a wormhole. People also refer to as stargates or portals or stargates, which are maybe the same, maybe similar type of thing. Stargates, where you go through this and you find yourself in a different locale altogether. You may have traveled, gone, a million light years or something, and you did it and just like that, actually. Some say the Mayans actually went through a wormhole or a stargate and disappeared from this planet. It's quite possible, huh? So we need to be opening our minds and calmly focusing on inquiry, on looking, and resolving the deep fears within ourselves, and recognizing that from a spiritual standpoint, our only problem is the continuity problem. Because we've had this death-based training program of, we call it permanence existence, all this stuff, everything's impermanent. Jesus said, don't store up your treasures in this world, meaning the realm of impermanence. Do not store it up in the world to come, as it were, which is the higher world. permanence. But how do we drop what we're used to and get and accept something we're not used to? You see, that's called a continuity problem. And so that is the real problem that we have. And then I've been told that the Holy Spirit is the one that has the solution to the continuity problem. So I continuously point out, how do we solve this continuity problem? How do we, and Jesus says forgiveness is very important, and I found that that is true also. So there are ways to prepare for the rapture, actually. That's what I've been doing for a long time. I know the comet's coming, I know the problems are coming, no question about it. But prepare to sidestep it all. You know, don't just sit there like a deer in headlights, say, you know, it's coming, and say, okay, but let's prepare. That's the attitude to have. And a lot of people actually have been preparing a lot. They've not been saying a lot about doom and gloom, but they're saying, we know that there's a big change coming, and we're getting ready for it. So again, it is all happening now. It is obvious. It is obvious. And there are some very bright people now posting on YouTube and various blogs who really have, you know, are piecing some of it together and have got some really key insights about what's going on. It's amazing stuff, actually. You recognize the players and who's in, what's going on in the world. It's, the Antichrist is an agenda, and this agenda is being pushed on the planet to an extraordinary extent. And so you don't have to be an expert in all that stuff. Like I said, I don't spend much time on it. I already kind of get an intuitive sense, like, let's prepare for the rapture, absolutely. Wormhole rapture. We're not going to grow wings and, you know, fly up in the sky or something. I don't think so. No, wormhole rapture. It's like stepping through, across the threshold. You know, a narrow gate. Jesus said, narrow gate, like a wormhole. You step across the threshold. And somehow, it's an amazing thing, somehow you step into another dimension, another time and place, as it were. So, there's a lot of talk about ISON, but I would say that the signs are there. The signs are there. And it's so heavy with signs right now, and there's so many prophets speaking up now. It's something that you need to say, hey, you know what? You know, this wouldn't be surprise me at all if these are the times. Wouldn't be surprising at all. And the naysayers, of course, they're always going to, they don't want to be bothered. They don't want to miss their favorite television shows or something. So they don't want to be bothered. You know, they say, you crazy, wacko, whatever. Yeah. All right, that's fine. Fine for them. But I think the more intelligent people on the planet realize that there is this constellation, overall situation brewing, very much brewing. And so people more and more need to kind of accept, say, you know what? I think I really feel intuitively, I feel that we're at these times now that we've been told about. The great change, you know, the great tribulation and all this kind of stuff. And you don't need to suffer. You don't need to stay here, suffer through it all. You know, you don't. Absolutely don't. That's what my videos point out and explain to you why you don't need to suffer, etc. So, if you know it's coming, prepare for it. It's that simple. And if nothing happens and everything's fine, at the very least, you've done tremendous spiritual work, which will lead to enlightenment, actually, to your salvation. Absolutely. So it's a win-win scenario when you prepare for wormhole rapture, to be saved from the tribulation and not go through it, which we have been promised. We've been promised. If we prepare, we will not have to go through the tribulation. That is what Jesus promised us. Okay? So, it's a win-win. We can't lose when you prepare like that way. Can't lose. It's the safe way. The safe way is to make the preparations. See, always Jesus always said in his parable, say, be vigilant, vigilant, vigilant. Be prepared, be prepared, be prepared. Don't be caught unprepared at that end time. because he says, when I return, and he said the problems will come like a thief in the night. Like a thief in the night. What comes like a thief in the night? Fragments from a comet, for sure. And so he said, you got to be prepared and heed the warnings of the prophets. The sign of Jonah, apparently, you know, looks like we've been given the sign of Jonah now at this time. I mean, so it's counting down, as it were, to the beginning of a period, the tribulation period, really the destruction, the bringing about of a collapse of the civilization. I've just been shown what's going to happen from the standpoint of enormous collapse of rock coming into this planet that just kicks up an enormous amount of dust. Okay, well, that's what I've been shown. Is the problem is going to be the amount of dust in the atmosphere, actually. Because, of course, you're talking about fragments. How big is this ISON? It's like, but maybe 5 miles in diameter at tops, maybe. And maybe it's bigger, but it's a fairly substantial-sized comet. It's not a little pea shooter, you know. It's like 5 miles is pretty big. From 2 to 5 miles, you know, and maybe a little smaller, maybe even bigger. But and there it could be towing asteroid fragments with it in its debris field. But at any rate, if it breaks up, and they say 5 fragments, well, what are they, 1 mile in diameter or something? Well, that clunks down in the ocean somewhere. I mean, what was it, 3/4 of the world is ocean? So it's likely, is just from a statistical standpoint, it's there's a lot of likelihood. I mean, the angle of things might skew it a little bit, you know, so maybe you can't draw a direct correlation between this, but it, you know, it's likely that some fragments will hit water, for instance. Well, a mile diameter fragment going at the speed of a comet, that's incredible speed, going into the ocean is first of all, it's going to produce an enormous heat wave, atmospheric heat wave, just an incredibly hot. It's going to heat the atmosphere. That speed, the kinetic energy, is just going to create the most intense heat, which will just cause enormous atmospheric disturbance, actually. And then actually going into the ocean, the intense velocity and heat is just going to vaporize an incredible amount of water, actually. And that will also create like this like vacuum-like effect in the ocean, which will then the ocean waters will rush into that area, and creating enormous turbulence like tsunamis. Also, it's likely it could very well, you know, hit the ground beneath the ocean and go deep into that. And just the intense heat of the whole situation is going to cause enormous reactions. And then on land, if it hit land, the intense heat and the dust that it would kick up is just enormous. And so, the dust, the atmosphere will become what I've been seeing is so much dust and then dark and then rain drizzling down. There was a lot of steam, a lot of moisture in the atmosphere. And again, it could be electromagnetic pulses, EMPs from the fragments coming in and just the overall debris field of the comet, the static electricity, various stuff could happen. So it's a turbulent scenario, actually, very turbulent scenario that ISON could very well bring with it. And again, just tremendous dust in the atmosphere blocking out the sun, causing crop failures and just upheaval and turbulence and just, you know, tribulation, period of time of utmost difficulty for everything on the planet. A big upheaval and change. Is people have been telling, you know, warning about this for a long time. And it looks like it could be arriving. We'll see. Hopefully nothing happens, actually. Because really, we don't wish ill upon anyone. Because the worst of people, what they're suffering from is really bad habits. Because they're ignorant of the Holy Spirit, that God has created the Holy Spirit to solve the continuity problem. They're ignorant of that. So they've have very bad, their habits have gotten really, 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 really bad, really anti-Christ. But they're going to be saved eventually too, actually, because the continuity problem has been solved for all, for all, for all. Okay, so it's just a matter of time. Eventually they will shed those bad habits to some extent and accept the Holy Spirit's remedy, eventually. So I don't wish ill upon anybody. Absolutely not. We all have our differences here in the world, and we're all gnashing our teeth at what's going on. But as far as really wishing ill upon someone else, no. No way. We're all one, actually. We're all one spirit with many facets to it. So hopefully nothing bad happens at all, and we can somehow, keep going on in some way. It doesn't look so bright, the future, though, does it? The way things are going here, the Antichrist agenda is really problematical, actually. Very problematical. It's not looking so bright. The future's not looking so bright. So, we will see. Stay tuned to this channel. I will give updates on if something comes up on ISON, and I'll continue to prepare us for enlightened salvation and, at the same time, rapture as well. Absolutely. I call it sidestepping the tribulation, sidestepping the troubles that are to come. That's why I've always said, sidestep them. See, it's you don't resolve them, you don't solve them. You're just in a different place where they're not happening. The problems aren't happening. You're not there. You're not really, you're not in the world anymore. Somehow you've sidestepped this planet as it goes through the tribulations. This is the promise I believe Jesus gave to us and said that you will be able to sidestep the troubles when they come. If you are prepared, if you are vigilant, if you're ready, if you're willing, done the right preparation, then you will certainly succeed. Those are the real Christians that Jesus will be calling the elect of God. Those who have decided they're going to prepare are going to get their reward at this time. Absolutely. Absolutely. So I'm with everybody that is working on this situation, actually. And everybody has a different way of expressing things, you know. So I don't get too caught up or concerned about different expressions and the ways that people think about various things and stuff. You say, well, if they make a contribution, they make a contribution, you know. Truth is where you find it. You find a little bit here, you find a little bit there. You keep collecting as much truth as you can. And if somebody says something that just seems a little off track, you say, okay, you know, maybe it's off track. But it's difficult to put it all together. So don't waste time. Don't argue. Don't be bothered. Just thank them for their contribution that they made. That's all. So I will put a link in this description of this video to Steve Fletcher's blog or website or whatever. You can look at this, the 40 days, the sign of the whale, sign of Jonah, pictures, etc., to look at. It's actually very, very interesting. Very interesting. If it's true. I'm not sure if the moon was really there or not, but I just have to accept that somebody did the work, and indeed that's where the moon actually was. And I have no reason to think that otherwise. And we will continue on. We will continue on with urgency. I couldn't sleep last night. Horrible night. My back has seized up on me. I can hardly walk. You know, stuff is happening. We're realizing, whoa, you know, this is the 40-day countdown, as it were. We're counting it down. And I tell you, great things will happen in this period now. Great things will happen. I fully expect it. The end of October has always been an incredible time for me. Incredible time of breakthroughs. And what's today? Today's the 21st. Yeah, it's the 21st. So the next week is the time. So I'm really looking forward to these times, and I hope you are too. Don't shrink from the times. We're no shrinking violets, okay? No, absolutely not. We embrace the times. These are our times. These are the times we prepared for. We're ready for these times. It's the other people who are not ready, who haven't prepared. I'm raring to go. This is great, great, great times here. We are ready. Anytime, Jesus, you want to come back, welcome back. Happy to have you here, and happy to see how you're going to play the situation at this time. It's it'll be absolutely riveting, for sure. Very, very interesting. If Jesus comes back, will the mainstream media even report on it? Probably not. Probably not. But we won't miss it. We won't miss it, that is for sure. Because there are a lot of great people out there, a lot of minds that are keen and waking up and looking at stuff, and it's been a collective effort from everybody, and together we've all pushed this thing forward, you know, all pushed it forward, all doing work, all contributing, all reassuring, having the, you know, this attitude, and people have been very kind, you know, to one another, certainly kind to me, that is for sure, and I very much appreciate that, you know, the kindness that everybody has shown, because you know, it's not easy to always be kind. It takes a little effort for sure. And we all have to make that effort, you know. We all have to make that effort. And we have. We have people who have been working on this whole situation. I find that they're very kind. Very kind. And are able to conduct themselves in a very appropriate way. I've noticed that. And that's amazing, because the incivility in this world is absolutely incredible. The Antichrist, incivility, the Antichrist is just off the charts, you know. These people are just savaging one another, and it's just crazy. But somehow those who are with Jesus, with Christ, with salvation, with rapture, with sidestepping the tribulation, from all backgrounds, they have this sort of calm, peaceful, loving, civility, kindness, and forgiveness in them in some way, in some fashion. So that's great. Very, very much appreciated. Thank you, everyone. And just hang in there. Just hang in there. It's going to be a great ride from this day forward. I'm telling you, it's going to be a great ride. Breakthroughs, you don't know what the breakthroughs are going to be. They're just tremendous. And someday you may find yourself actually stepping through a wormhole. That is very, very possible. And you know what? We can do it. We can absolutely do it. Maybe that's my back season. If I can't even walk, the very idea that I've kind of stepped through a wormhole is causing my system to freeze up. That is for sure. But I'll get through it, and I'll loosen up and be fine. So everyone, hang in there and embrace the times that we are in. This is it. It is absolutely a grand adventure. All right. Very great. That's it.